Welcome to another wiring module. Today we're going to be talking about establishing a solid ground connection for your entire power system. So we're going to use a 2-gauge wire here, and what you're going to need is you're going to need your wire, you're going to need some wire cutters, and I'm also going to double these as strippers, and I'll show you how I do that. You're going to need a heat gun, and you're going to need an impact drill to drill into your frame. You're going to need an impact drill to drill into your chassis of your van. And you'll also need a bolt. I have a self-drilling bolt, and you'll need a few washers, and you will need a ring terminal for your proper gauge. So I got a 2-gauge ring terminal here. And you will also need a way to crimp this ring terminal onto your wire. I use a vice grip, but maybe you have a nice set of crimpers. These don't quite do it, but you will need that. So let's get into it. So after you got your hole drilled, you're gonna wanna run a wire to the proper length. So this is going to run from the chassis up to my negative bus bar. And I'm going to need ring terminals at both ends. I'm gonna start just on one end and see how far it reaches up. I may still cut this wire, but if not, I'm just gonna leave it how it is. I'm gonna put one ring terminal on it so I can attach it to my chassis here. And we're gonna get under the van after this step. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use my wire snippers, and I'm just gonna kind of do a little dance around the ring and try not to cut into the wire. Loosen it just enough so I can pull it off. And now I will get my terminal ring and slip it on. And now we will head to the vice grip to crimp this. I'm here at the vice grip, and I'm gonna show you how I crimp these wires with the vice grip. So let's pan down here. Here's the vice grip. I like to just put the terminal ring down here at the bottom so I'm not smashing the flat part. Just have it hanging out the bottom. I'll show you what it looks like. Have it hanging out the bottom there, because otherwise if you vice grip it, you'll smash your flat part there. So you don't want to do that. And then I'm just going to squeeze it down. So you just kind of want to put some pressure, get the vice grip tight enough, put some pressure down onto the cable, and then just twist it and give it a good squeeze. Nice and tight. The tighter the better. And then undo it, and then you can see I have a incredibly tight crimp there. So that's what you want. You want a great positive connection smashing that wire. And now we're gonna heat shrink it. This heat shrink on, and I got a heat gun here, got it at Harbor Freight, like I said in the last modules, 20 bucks, great buy. Makes your work look nice and clean, and let's hit it. So there we have it. I have a nice heat shrink on there. I really want it to be watertight because it's going under the chassis and I don't want any water getting in here. Since it is going under the chassis, I'm actually gonna double up on the heat shrink just so it gets no moisture or any water in there. So I choked it up a bit, and now I'm just gonna blast it again. Alrighty, looks great. Let's get over there and install this. First things first, I have a step bit on my drill here. This is a Lithely drill. I got it online. We actually have discounts for the kooks who want these tools, so check them out in the description. And a step bit, these are great. I got this at Harbor Freight. These are great for van builds because you can pop holes in metal and other stuff and get it to the size you want. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pop a hole here. There's already an existing hole. I'm just gonna drill down, then I'm gonna run my cord down through there. We're under the van. We're gonna go into the chassis here to establish a nice ground connection. And in order to do that, I'm gonna have to first start with the pre-drill. So I got my Lithely drill here, and I'm gonna pre-drill into the chassis here. And then I'm going to take a self-drilling stainless screw here with two stainless washers. You want stainless so they don't rust. And then you want a washer on the inside. And then you want to wash it on the outside so you get a nice ground connection. Also, I'm going to throw on some safety glasses since I'm drilling up. So I'll just make a little pre-drill here into the frame. All right, so I got it partially in, and I want to make sure that the cable's running up nice and clean. So I'm going to shimmy it up like so. Got it in. It's very solid connection. I hit it with the ratchet gun pretty good, and it's in there. I'm really happy with how secure it is. Make sure you use those stainless bolts. So there's a closer look at it. I just have it attached here to the chassis, and then I have that bolt in there, and it is in there tight. I threw a few extra washers on there just so I could have a better positive connection there against the frame, and I'm happy with it. Now let's get in the van. Let's hook up our bus bar and establish a good ground, and then we can get going on our wiring our batteries in parallel and installing them. Okay, so I've installed my heavy duty negative bus bar here, and I'm just going to cut this wire here, and I'm gonna crimp on a terminal end. All right, so I got it crimped. I got my heat gun, and I'm just gonna hit it here. And I will attach it to my bus bar. And with this, you can either use a bus bar or you can just take this ground and connect it directly to your battery. I like to use the bus bar. It keeps everything a little more easier to wire when we put everything together. But it can either go to the negative terminal of your battery bank or a bus bar, and then your battery bank will have to hook up to your bus bar to ground it. So we're gonna do it off the bus bar. But if you weren't using the bus bar, you can just go ahead and connect it directly to your batteries. All right, so we got the batteries in the van, and I got my shunt here because I have a Renogy battery monitor here, and the shunt's gonna need to be hooked up to the ground, and that's gonna help ground the battery. So I got it hooked up here. And before I get into all this, I gotta cut and crimp another wire. So I need a wire to go from my negative here to the B minus here on the Renogy battery monitor shunt. So what I'll be working on now is just I'll cut and crimp this, and then I'm going to need one to go from the P minus to the ground. So I'm going to have to do a few more cutting and crimping of wires before I'm ready to set my battery bank up. So I'm going to go ahead and strip these wires, throw some terminal ends on here and heat shrink them. And then I'm gonna cut this as well, and then I'll come back and we'll tie it all together. Okay, so I'm hooking up my shunt here. I'm gonna go ahead and throw my freshly cut, crimped, and heat shrinked wire onto the battery terminal here. And this is going to attach to this terminal, but first I just need to get it all in place. So I'll speed it all up for you guys. All right, so I got my shunt in place for my Renogy battery monitor, and that is hooked up to the bus bar, and it's gonna hook up to the battery here. And now I'm just going to wire my batteries in parallel. So I'm gonna use the provided screws from Battleborn, and I'm just gonna hook them all up. And I'll show you how I do it. I'm just gonna show you in a quick time lapse, and then that way it's easy to follow along. But basically, we're just chaining them together, positive to positive and negative to negative. It's a quick, easy process. So I forgot to show you on that setup how to check to see if your ground is good. So we are actually gonna check the resistance. So we're gonna go to this ohm sign here. And basically we can just measure what the ground is off of the two negative posts here. And you see I dropped down 1.2, it'll drop down even lower. But basically we want to establish our ground and make sure that what we just set up is about equal to this number. So what we're gonna do, we want as close to zero as possible. So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna hit it to my bus bar back here. Okay, so there you can see it's down, it's about the same. 1.2, which is good. I don't want it to be something like, you know, 1. 1 is bad. I want it basically 0. 0 is an ideal number for us, but anywhere very close to 0 is going to be totally fine. So here it is on my bus bar. So there it is again on my bus bar. It's under 1, and that bus bar is ground just straight to the chassis of the vehicle. So this is a good ground. This is great. Anything near 0 is almost perfect. And you're just going to do that. You're going to set it to your ohm here. All right, Kooks, I hope this video was helpful. I hope this showed you how to establish a good ground connection in your 12-volt system. The ground connection is very important. It'll assure you aren't getting any voltage drop. So you will need that multimeter to check the resistance there at the end. And just remember, you want it anywhere close to 0. So thanks for watching this video, you Kooks. I hope this was helpful. If it is, leave a comment, give it a thumbs up, like, and subscribe. And we will see you guys soon. And also check out the Van Kooks Masterclass. Sign up early and get a 10% discount. And it's coming soon. So check that inbox. And thank you so much for watching. And we will see you guys next time.